Hello, everybody, and welcome tonight to our workshop of taking care of ourselves, how social and emotional learning as facilitating leads to healing. Thank you so much for calling in tonight. I hope that this is something that can be very helpful for you as you're starting this semester, either here at the university or wherever you are at this time. This is like a new beginning, but we're still in some of the same old things that we've been doing. So tonight we're going to talk about how are we taking care of ourselves as we go through this semester. So tonight, I'm Laura Mitchell, and I am associate professor in the Department of Urban Education. Bilingual education is my area of expertise. And I have with me tonight several people that I'd like to introduce. First of all, the director for the Center for Public Service is Stephen Villano, and he is here. Stephen, can you say something to the group?
Hello, everyone, and welcome. We're so glad that you're able to join us tonight. I'm so happy that the center was able to be involved in presenting this session to you, because I think this is going to be just really important for us all to realize that we've got to take care of ourselves in order to be public servants, to be able to take care of other people, to continue to do that. So I'm so glad that Dr. Mitchell is going to be sharing what she's learned and breathe for change, and so that we can all breathe easy as we take care of this new semester and beyond. So enjoy.
Thank you. And Stephen's going to help us. We have the chat open and question and answer. So I'm going to ask you to put things into chat and periodically through tonight, because normally I do a very interactive teaching on Zoom, and with the setup we have tonight, and we can't be as interactive as I would like. So we're going to do it through chat. And then there's also the feature of question and answer. So if you have some questions or comments that you want to put in too, just put those in. And then as they come in, Stephen will interrupt me and that's okay. On Zoom, that's an okay manner to do. And then he will read them and talk about it. So one of my other guests that's with us tonight, a special guest, is Dean Schwartz. And he's the one who really has been making this possible by listening to my vision of what I want to do and just giving me some permission to keep moving forward and supporting me through this. So welcome, Dean Schwartz, and I'd like for you to say a few things tonight.
Well, thank you, Laura, and welcome. I think most of you are probably familiar with the College of Public Service. But if you're not, I think we're an amazing college. We're an award-winning college with programs in education where we train teachers, criminal justice professionals, and social workers, and soon to be educational leaders. So welcome. I think this is an amazing topic, especially now. I know people have been struggling with COVID, financial difficulties. It's just been a hard time. So I think this is always important, but now more than ever. So I appreciate Dr. Mitchell giving this presentation, and I'm looking forward to it. So thank you all for joining us.
Thank you so much. And so yes, thank you for joining in tonight. I know I can't see you right now, and others are taking care of a few things to make this work. So I'm just so glad you're here. I know I have my students are here. Several of my colleagues, and I'm just thank you so much for calling in. So to get us started, I just want to tell you how some of this started for me. So when we did go into the quarantine, I was feeling very stressed and anxious, and I had been already working with this group called Breathe for Change. And they are an awesome group, and you're welcome to look up, research them, look them up. And the person here in the purple shirt is the founding director. And so they put all of this program, social emotional learning, and self and mindfulness movement with yoga. They put it all online, all the training. So I've been doing this all through this time, and that anxiety and worry is still there, but I have strategies to help me take care of myself and then to take care of my family and my students and others, because we carry such a huge load. And I know that many of you are taking care of so many others in your family. Yeah, you're teaching or you're planning to be teachers or you're working out in the community in different ways. And it's an anxiety kind of level. And so tonight I'm going to bring to you some of the things I've learned through this group about how to be, how to breathe and how to be mindful about what you're, what we're doing. So as we move through tonight, a couple of things I invite you to do is to find a comfortable place to sit. You can sit, stand, lay down, sit on the floor, anything that makes you feel comfortable. I invite you to have with you some journal paper, color paper, anything. I love to use color, sticky notes. My students know I love all these things, pens. We're going to do a few things where we make some lists, and then we also do some writing with it. So you might want to have some of that close. But most important is we're going to do some activities, some of them with some movement. We'll stay in our chairs tonight. No yoga movements, no standing on your head, or downward facing dog tonight. But we will do some active kind of things. And I hope you join in with me. You're invited to join in with me. So to get us started, I want to share with you about social and emotional learning competencies. And this wheel, this competency wheel comes from the CASEL organization. Daniel Goleman is one of the leading people in this field. And I used social emotional learning for all my years that I was at Buffalo Creek Elementary in Spring Branch. But one of the things that is different with Breathe for Change is not only did we take these strategies and do things with our students, but the Breathe for Change brings these, helps us focus these strategies, the self-awareness, the self-management on ourselves first. So if we take care of ourselves first, we make sure we are aware of our emotions. We are aware how we're feeling, and when we're feeling good, how that feels. When we're not feeling good, what is that like? And then how we manage that, and then build our social awareness with our networks of colleagues, friends, and family, building relationships, making responsible decisions. When we're able to do that with ourselves, then we can take that to others around us. For me, it was taking it to students, to children like second graders, and teaching them what does it feel like to be angry? What does it feel like to be mad? And to continue just what happens when you're angry? Do you hit? So that hitting feeling when you're mad, you hit somebody, you learn to do that maybe with brothers and sisters, and that just happens. That's the way the family is. That's the way my family was. I had three brothers and we did a lot of hitting. But you know, in school, we can't do that. And so we want to help our students learn how to manage that feeling. And so asking students, okay, so how are you feeling today? And they say, well, I'm really mad because, and you know, it could be a wide range of reasons. And then you say, okay, so what can you do? And in that way, you're teaching the students, you're even teaching yourself to take strategies and plans of what you can do when you have certain kinds of emotions. Something that might take you away from something like hitting, hurting someone else, hurting yourself. And so that's what I think is so wonderful about social emotional learning. But the most important thing is first about yourself, being able to follow this wheel in terms of self-management, self-awareness for yourself. And that's where we pretty much are today with this, all these news, the news that we have, the media, the announcements that come through our phones and come through our computer, how things like just the university deciding to stay virtual through February, then through March. Those are stressful situations, good or bad, no matter how you feel, that brings a stress in us. And then we go, okay, so I'm going to talk to you tonight about some ways that you can actually manage some of that stress and think about how that makes you feel. So what I'd like you to do is settle in with me, and we're going to do a chime in and then a chair twist and a side bend. So when you settle in, you are creating a calming situation. You know, we've been taking time to get everybody in. I don't know how it's been for you to get the link. Could you find it? Did your internet work? Are you muted? All those things that happen, even in Zoom, takes a minute, takes some time to get settled in. But the same thing in the classroom, getting in, finding that parking spot, getting to class, sitting down. Do I have my homework? Did I bring this? Oh, am I in the right classroom? All those anxiety feelings you feel, you want to have a time to settle in. So we're going to settle in as a group. And that brings in this calming, calming environment. And I'm going to create this safe space for us tonight so we can breathe, we can think, be creative, and explore some of our emotions and how we're feeling. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to play a chime. And when you don't hear it, you will hear the chime. And when you don't hear it, when it stops, I want you to make a symbol with your hand. Either I like to do a heart, peace. One of my favorites we've been doing is peace out. Cool, I'm cool, peace out. Kind of to express how you're feeling. Now, I don't get to see it, and I'm sorry for that, but I still think it makes you feel good. So, you know, you could do a hang 10 or I love you. Just any kind of thing. These are some kisses. I've been learning some different movements for Zoom. So here's some kisses. And then of course, high five. So anything that kind of says how you feel. So first, just find a place to sit. Put your feet to the ground. Ground your feet in to the earth. Make your spine nice and long. And then just listen to your breathing. Ready? Here we go. All right, when you don't hear it anymore, put up your symbol. This is mine. Now take a deep breath and let it out. Do you feel a little calmness about you? So I hope you feel calm. I hope this makes you feel a little bit better. So while you're sitting in your chair, kind of scoot back and sit up straight. And let's just do a few movements to help us loosen up a little bit. So a couple things to do is put your shoulders up and then just draw your shoulder blades back behind you and then bring them down. And do it while you take a deep breath, bring your shoulders up. And then let it out and roll your shoulder blades back. And do that one more time. And then roll it back. And now we're gonna do a chair twist. So you may be sitting in your chair. You may have a sidearm to hold on to, whatever works for you. And we may not look exactly the same with mirroring the Zoom. So just, you know, do what feels good to you. But I'm gonna put your left hand over your right knee. And face to the right. Put your right hand behind you. And just stretch, sit up tall, and just twist. Take a deep breath. And on your exhale, come to center. I hope that felt good. This time, take your right hand, put it on your left knee, and then turn to the left. Stretch, and take a deep breath. And on your exhale, come to center. So let's do one more chair twist. Left hand on your right knee, turn to the right and just twist. And this time turn your neck just a little bit carefully to look behind, almost behind you. Do that very carefully, don't strain your neck. And then take a deep breath and come to center. Now take your right hand, put on your left knee and then turn. Take a deep breath and then look back behind you and do a big stretch. Very careful with your neck. And then take a deep breath. Exhale, come to center. And now do a side bend. Right hand, left arm up. Open up your rib cage and just lean over to the right. And your right hand can be on this chair or behind you or supporting your back. And just stretch, open up the rib cage, and then come to center. Now do the right side, open up, put the right arm over, and open up that side. Hold your left hand behind you or on the side of the chair. Take a deep breath, let it out, and come to center. Okay. So now think about how you feel. Breathe. You feel a little bit better? I hope you do, because I know another thing that happens to us is that we are on Zoom all day. I don't know about you, but we have meetings at the university and in my classes and in conferences. And we have what we're all finding Zoom fatigue, no matter what program or platform we're using. And just think about our students in school who are working virtually or even sitting in their chairs because they can't get up and move around at school. So teaching them to do a few twists or to shoulder releases, those kind of things can help our children release some muscles they may not even know are tight because it's never happened to them before. They've always been about moving about and doing things, and all of a sudden they have Zoom fatigue. They're on Zoom virtually or they're sitting at a desk. So those are some things to think about. So I hope you feel a little bit better. What I want to talk about with you as we go through here is to think about this learning zone of this graph I have. So with your breath, a couple things happen to us. Our breath communicates to our brain, and then our brain communicates to the rest of our body what to do. So if you're in a comfort zone, let's say you're at home, you're in your pajamas, you're all nice and comfy, you feel really good, and you're just calm and watching a movie with your family and just being comfortable. Your brain says, oh, we're safe. Everything is good. And you just relax. Sometimes you might even fall asleep watching that movie because you're so relaxed. And your brain says, everything is safe. We don't have to worry about anything because your breath is calm. So sometimes when we are learning something new, when we are challenging ourselves to do something different, we move into the green zone or the growth zone. And oftentimes that's where we live as students, teachers, professors. All of us live in this zone a lot because we're learning new things. We challenge ourselves. Like I challenged myself to learn yoga. And so that can be in the growth zone. The trouble with all these zones is we actually have been living in the panic zone more than we've ever had before. You get an alert on your phone and you just, what is it? What is it? What's happened? What is this about? You know, or we find out somebody has died. Like when I just saw that Cicely Tyson has passed away. And I'm like, oh, and that puts me into that panic zone. Even though that for me is not a major issue, but we live in this kind of panic all the time. What's next? What's gonna happen? Who says what? Who does what? So we've been in the panic zone a lot. And what happens is that fear, you get an alert, you have a fear, and your breath becomes short and in the chest, and you're sending messages to your brain, and your brain is going, wait, something's wrong. Fight? Are we ready to fight? Or flight? Or freeze? And freeze means you're going to shut down. Often a kindergartner will live in fight or flight. Think about a kindergartner, first grader who's brand new to school. You know, they come in and they're scared. And so they might start throwing fists. I've seen it where a kindergartner can take out the whole playground because they're scared and they start fighting. Or my other favorite is when a kindergartner runs because they're so scared. You've seen that a child just runs. That's a fight or flight. And that comes in from what our brain is telling us to do. What adults do mostly, you don't fight, you don't run because, you know, that's not appropriate, but you freeze and you might shut down.
Excuse me, Dr. Mitchell?
Yes, sir.
I'm sorry to interrupt you, but are we supposed to be seeing your screen?
Oh my gosh, are you not seeing it?
We're not seeing it.
Oh, okay. Has it been okay talking? So I guess somebody forgot to tell me I needed to share my screen, right?
Yep.
Oh, I'm sorry. Thank you for telling me that. You should have told me a lot earlier, Mr. Villano.
I'm sorry.
I'm sorry too. Okay. What do you see now?
Yep. Perfect.
Well, yay. One of our first ones, right? So thank you so much for doing that and for interrupting me. So I've been showing you beautiful slides, by the way, and this happens in my class all the time too. I'm talking away. So thank you for interrupting me. And I'm so sorry for that. I hope that hasn't been too inconvenient for you. Okay, so thinking about fight, flight, or freeze, think about where we might be if we move into that panic zone. So we're going to do two breathing activities. First, we're going to do a shallow breathing activity. And what I'd like you to do is just sit in your chair like you were sitting earlier and just take some short breaths. Don't just make short, shallow breathing. Even think, scared, frightened. Do that with me. Okay, and then now what I want you to do is we're going to do some belly breathing, and that means you're going to breathe deep. So you put your hands on your belly, just right in front of you, and then I want to take you to take a deep breath, and I'll count to five, and then you hold it, and then you let it out, and I'll count back to one. So let's try it. Breathe in, 1, 2, 3, 4. Five, hold it. Now let it out. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and hold it. Now when you breathe in, make sure your belly moves. Your hand feels your belly moving. Breathe in. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Hold it. Now let it out. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Now one more, and make that belly move. Make that real deep breath. Take a deep breath. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and hold it. Now let it out. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And just empty out your breath. Now, just breathe normal. Sit back a little bit and tell me, how are you feeling? So now compare the shallow breathing to the belly breathing. Does that make you feel better? Do you feel, with that deep breathing, do you feel a little bit more under control? You've communicated to your brain that everything's okay. So your brain is thinking, okay, we don't have to run, we don't have to fight. And then think about what that will do as you're in the comfort or growth zone. And this is where we'd like to be when we're learning and in the classroom, the growth zone. So as you're in that growth zone, what happens is the adrenaline is low, and then you have that cognitive thinking ability, and you can think. And just think what happens when you're thinking. You have creativity, you can feel things, you can make decisions. If you're in that shallow breathing mode and you're breathing short breaths, that'll move your brain into the panic zone. And then the adrenaline will increase and the brain will take over the movement. And that's where the fight, flight, or freeze will kick in. And it will keep you from thinking. All you are thinking about now is how to survive. Where is the danger? What do I need to do? You don't get to think, you know, good creative thoughts. You don't get to think making good decisions. And so that's why breathing is so important. And it does calm your mind. It cultivates awareness. And I encourage you to find a time, 5 minutes, to take out in the morning, after lunch. Take some time and just do some kind of deep breathing, something like that, to help calm you, to help recenter you, to give you that feeling that you're okay. I do it before I go to bed. I do that kind of breathing and I go to sleep that way. Before I was doing this, I woke up several times in the middle of the night in a panic attack. And I'm like, oh my gosh, what's going on? Oh, and I'm okay. And that was so scary. And so now doing the deep breathing right before I go to sleep at night, I sleep through the night usually. I sleep so much better. And that's what I'd like for you to try too. So I hope you get to practice some of these kind of breathing exercises. I know that there's a lot of people out there that are doing different kinds of mindfulness. And I hope that you find something that works for you, either listening to something, listening to some music, whatever works, just find something to try. That's the main part of taking care of yourself is breathing. And think about how simple that is. It really doesn't cost anything. You don't have to go to a gym to breathe, to take some breathing time for yourself to breathe. Sometimes we think taking care of ourselves means, oh, I've got to eat right. I should be eating a better diet, which, yeah, we all do. But, you know, that doesn't always happen. And then the other side, I will say how are you taking care of yourself? And they'll say, well, I was supposed to go to the gym this week, but I haven't gone. Or I was going to do some swimming at the Y, but I couldn't do that. And, of course, they closed for a while. So I just can't take care of myself. Well, what taking care of yourself doesn't mean the big things to do, but it also means the little things. And so breathing, like we just did, is one way to take care of yourself. Take a 5-minute break. Close your eyes. Close out the world. Close out the alerts, the cell phone, all those things that keep us in that panic zone. And just take a 5-minute break with your breath. So those are some ways to take care of yourself. We'll talk about some more as we go through today. Okay, so let's do some movement. Let's get going. I hope you already did the twist and kind of moved around to get yourself loosened up. We're gonna try sitting in your chair and do a half sun salutation. That's a yoga move, or you can think of it as a sun dance. And then we're going to move into a mountain pose, just sitting in our chair, and we're going to grow a tree. And unfortunately, we don't have everybody on Zoom to see it, but it's really cool. But we can still imagine how we're connecting with each other in our squares that we have. We're going to reach out and we're going to clasp hands with each other. And we're going to be a community together, so that even though we might all be at home and alone, or with just our family, we're still connected in our community together. And tonight, we're connected together. So here's how we'll do it. A half sun salutation. Just sit real tall in your chair and then bring your arms up over your head. Look up at your hands and then bring them to your heart. Can you do that with me? And when you do that, when you bring your hands up, take a deep breath and then let it out. Let's do it one more time. Ready? Hands up, breathe in, clasp your palms, and bring them to your heart and let your air out. And make that audible sound. I wish I could hear y'all. One more time. Hands up, kiss your palms, and then bring them down to your heart. Now, the next time we do this, we're gonna fold forward. So find a place. I'm scooting back so I have some space to move with. So bring your arms up and then fold all the way forward. Touch your toes or your shins and just come down a little bit and hang your head and then slowly roll back up. Put your hands on your knees and make your back straight and come up. One more time, hands up, and then bring them down and fold forward. Come down, touch your toes, hands on your shin or your toes or the floor. Hang your head and just kind of be a rag doll for just a moment. And then bring your hands up slowly, roll up, hands on your knees, make your back straight, and come up. One more. Here we go. Hands up, fold forward, touch your toes, hang your head, bring your hands to your knees and make your back straight, and then come to center. So that's your sun salutation in a chair, and that's becoming a really popular yoga is a chair yoga, not just for people like me who are older, and my friends that want to do it that way. This is something you can do in an office with your students. Just, you know, instead of having them get up or having to find a place, a mat and all that stuff that yoga involves sometimes, just take an energizing break and do a sun dance. You can even ask them to twist and then come down and fall forward. So that's a nice way to get some energy going. So the next thing I want to do is that mountain pose. So what we're going to do is we're going to make ourselves nice and straight and strong. So sitting in your chair, you just make your back long, your spine long. Hold your head up straight. Feel the crown of your head. Breathe in. And let out an audible sound. Now, as you have this power in you, I want you to bring your hands up and stretch, and then bring them to the side like this, just a little bit more so you can see my hands. And then hold your hands up like a tree and just swing back and forth. If we had everybody on the Zoom, you would see each other just swinging. So please think of ways you might do this in your classes or with your students or with your family. All right, and then hold it and then come down. And then my favorite pose, and it's hard for you to see the way I have everything set up, is just a power pose. So as you're up tall and straight, put your hands to your side at your waist and just stand like you're a superhuman because you have superpowers. And just hold it, close your eyes if you want or have a soft focus. Breathe in, breathe out. And then think about your power that you have, the power you have in your arms, in your legs, the power you have in your body, and the power for who you are, and your superhuman power. I did this with my family and one of the kids in our family. He stopped and I was telling him, you are a superhuman, you have superhuman powers. And then he goes like this and he makes this power move, and it was like so cool, and he really thought of himself as a superhuman. I love that, and that's the thing we need to do. So come back to center, put your hands at your heart, breathe deep. Thank you for doing that with me. I hope you did it. You know, I don't have any way to check to make sure you did do it. If you didn't do it, you can think about doing some of that later. Or if you think about how you can do that with your with students, give them that sense of being having that movement, the energizing. And then I put this picture up because this was how the Breathe for Change training was done before virtual. And so this is what we call a group pose. It's doing the mountain pose. Tree pose, and they're holding onto each other, supporting each other in community. And that's what I want you guys to think about as we are doing this tonight. As you're starting the semester, you are in community. You are with us. Wherever you are, that you have us as a community. And we're in community tonight together. You're not alone. And those things are really important for us to do. So, Stephen, where are we right now? Do we have anybody calling, having any questions?
Ironically enough, I just asked that in the chat, if anyone had any questions. So we will see momentarily if anyone does.
Well, I will give you something to put in the chat if you would like. So right now, if you could go to the chat, I got them to able to make it work for us. So go to the chat and put in two words to describe how you're feeling right now. Two words of maybe emotions about how you're feeling after all this deep breathing and movement. Are you feeling happy? Are you sad? Are you excited? Are you anxious about the semester? Are you worried? Are you looking forward to something? So put in some two words in the chat and just let us know how you're feeling right now. And as you're doing that, when you feel like you have some to read, you can read to me.
All right. One person, Abby, says she's excited and worried.
Okay. Any more? Just keep on putting them in, guys. We'll read them. We want to hear from you what you're thinking.
Another student is anxious and worried. So two worries.
Yeah.
Tense but calm, energized, overwhelmed and busy, hopeful, scattered, full, calm and satisfied, exhausted but trying to relax, overwhelmed but winding down, hopeful and grateful, calm but anxious, calm, overwhelmed, another calm and overwhelmed, calm. I should try to do this every time I'm worried or stressed. Calm and hopeful now, overwhelmed and tired, tired but hopeful, relaxed and optimistic, full oxygen,
calm. Ah, I love it.
Anxious but calm when my nephew's around. Maybe remind people, calmed and thoughtful and tired. And then we have Professor Miller had a question. She wanted to know if you do this for each class meeting or you just demonstrate it a few times.
Oh, that's a great question, Dr. Miller. So what I have been doing, my students know me as the professor that says to breathe. They used to, even before I started this activity and this kind of work, I would always tell my students, okay, we need to breathe, come on, because you know how they just get so worried about things. But now I start every class out with some kind of breathing activity. And I would do this with my university students, my master's students, but I would also do this all the way down to kinder. I've seen examples of doing this with kinders, four-year-olds, middle school students. You have to make them feel cool when they do it, but you can do this with all level. And then what we're doing right now is kind of taking a climate of the group or the class. And I like to do a beginning. I didn't quite do it at the very beginning, but just how are you feeling now? And then how are you feeling at the end? I'll do it as a closure too. We'll do some breathing at the end. And then I'll do a closure and I'll ask, put in two words, how do you feel now? And I'm looking, I'm hoping that we, as you heard, there was a lot of words like nervous, anxious, worried, but we also had calm. I love the calm and anxious together. That really says, kind of describes us right now, how we all are feeling. Then I look for the end of the class. I'm hoping that I will get, when they put in the two-word chat, they will put in that they are calm. They feel like they know what's expected of them. All those kind of things that I like to end the class with. So yes, we do breathing at the beginning of class and at the end of class. And I haven't yet, because of all the virtual work, I haven't yet done it, but I can't wait to get to the Wesley Community Center and do this with our students there. I think that they will really love this. Great question. Thank you. Anything else, Mr. Villano?
No, we don't have anything at this moment.
All right. Thank you for participating in that. And it helps me know there's people out there. So yay, you're doing great. This is awesome. So what I'd like for us, there we go. I finally found where, how many people at least are here. So yay, I'm glad you're here. What I'd like us to do now is I want us to move into a think, pair, share activity. And because of the fact that this is a webinar and I don't have as much interaction with you, we can still do the think, pair, share, but some of this activity can come in from the chat again. That was a nice test to see how that worked and that it does work. And so we're gonna do a strategy that we learn in school, in schools, literacy, classrooms, all kinds of ways we do this. So a think, pair, share basically means first, we think about something in our head. We process it first in our head. So what I want you to think about is ways that we take care of ourselves. What do we do? And then in a pair, like you see in the picture, you might turn to a partner. You might talk at a table to a small group about what are some of the things you thought about in your head. And then the share part is that you share out to everybody. Now, one of the reasons I bring Think, Pair, Share to us tonight, and I use this extensively in my classes, and I hope you've seen it used or you have been a part of it, but this is a place to bring equity to a group or to a classroom. So if you first take time to think in your head, and you have your group, like if I'm working with second graders, I'll hold them so they don't share and talk. Because you have the blurter, you have the one who wants to say the first thing in their head, and they're just wanting to be first. And so they say the first thing in their head. So that also affects their thinking, but it affects others' thinking too. And so one of the things is you take moments to think in your head first. Then the pair part is especially important in equity. So you're gonna have people in any group, no matter where you are, adults, children, whoever you work with, you're gonna have some people who are very shy and don't wanna talk out. Some people who wanna talk all the time. I was the person who always had just knew I had the thing to say. I'm sure I have the right answer. But then I would talk over somebody who might have the right answer or something important to say, but then they go, oh, she's got it, she'll answer. So in pairs, everyone gets to share. And sometimes with English language learners, somebody's learning that English is a second language, this is a real good time for them to practice and rehearse what they want to say. So the pair part is you sit, talk to a partner, or in a small group. And then that shy person or somebody who is not sure if they are saying the right thing or doing the right thing can practice that with the group. And often what happens is the group goes, wow, that's a good idea, or yeah, that's really good. And so they get to rehearse what they're thinking, practice it, get that confidence and that feedback, that they get feedback so they get confident that what they have to say is important. And also everybody is offering something in the think, pair, share, in that pair part. Then the share is important also. So sometimes that quiet, shy person who may not normally talk out might now have the confidence to talk because they practiced it. And then others can share too. But sometimes if the quiet, shy person who doesn't want to talk to the whole group, somebody in their group can share what they have to say. So the equity you see, you can see the equity as all the voices get to be brought to the community, to the group. And that's something that we really need to think about as we move out into community of how do we bring all the voices in. And everybody has a voice. Everybody has important things to say. But sometimes we let, as teachers, we might forget and let the person who blurts out always answer. Or we might be the person who's always talking. And then that means somebody else, we take up that space. And then somebody else doesn't have any space to talk or share, so they just sit back and they become small. And what if they have a great idea? So that's why I think pair share is so important. So we're gonna try this here. So first I'm going to be quiet. And what I want you to do is think in your head, what are you doing to take care of yourselves? What are we doing to take care of ourselves? Just think in your head for a minute. I made a list too of things that I do to take care of myself, but you may have others. So look at the list I have: calling a friend, sitting outside, drinking a cup of tea, journaling, drawing, doodling. Those are just some ideas. But remember, we don't have to do the big things. It could be little things. So I'm gonna be quiet. Think in your head, what are the things that you do to take care of yourself? Now, on that piece of paper or journal that you brought, the way I thought we would do this is for you just to write down that list. Write down, make a list of things that you do. I started my list here. You might start a list on your own paper. Just write some things down that you do. Taking a walk. I have 3 cats. I'm surprised they're so quiet tonight. I was expecting a little bit of drama. But I go find one of my cats to pick up and hug and hold. Makes me feel better. I really love to visit my niece who has 5 little girls. And I go play and hold the kids and play with them. What are some other things? So as you're writing, now what we're going to do is share those ideas with us. So now in the chat, could you write a few things that you wrote on your list? You don't have to make your whole list, but maybe give us a couple of things that you do to take care of yourself just in a normal day. It doesn't have to be when you're the most stressed or scared or worried. Just what do you do? What are you doing to make sure that you're okay? Put that in the chat for us right now. And Mr. Villano is there to read your words and what you have.
We have someone shared, Alina shared that she walks or sleeps. Janiyah journals, but not that often. Sheena prays. Abby journals or speaks kindly to herself. Eddie listens to jazz. Francisco exercises. Rachel cooks, bakes, talks to friends, reads. Ashley does karaoke singing. Hayden works out. He plants some herbs, plays with their cat. Journaling and meditating for Khadija. Estella takes walks around her neighborhood. Richmond listens to music and watches sports. Shanajala, sorry if I messed up that name, paints. Riyasa reads poems. Andrea walks and listens to Gershwin. Diane writes, drinks wine, walks and works out. Estella takes a walk, listens to music in a dark room, takes a warm shower or talks to a friend and a few other things. Rebecca plays her guitar. She prays, journals, and watches podcasts. Diane gets a massage, a mani-pedi, or a hair blowout.
Ooh, I love that. Awesome. Oh, thank you so much for sharing your ideas. And you are so on target. Yes. Things that just make you feel a little bit better. Yes, I really wish I could go to the gym 2-3 times a week and work out. That's really hard to do these days. But that's a big thing. But little things are really important for us right now. So as you're thinking of all these things, I love the list. And we'll take this and just kind of print it out and keep it. And a reminder, it's a great list. I hope that you are creating your list in your journal or your paper that you have with you nearby and continue writing and continue adding to that list. And then what you can do is, you know, on those days that you're really tired and you've been working hard, either in your classes or in whatever you do, your work, just go to that list and say, what I've had not done recently. You know, I haven't called a friend lately. I need to call a friend and talk to my friend. Like I call a friend Linda and I say, hey, can you talk? Let's just talk for a little bit. And we'll just chatter about nothing, but it feels so good. You know how that feels. But keep that list close and add to it. Oh, I love the one that says, I'm realizing now that I like stretching. Yes, that's one of the things that has really happened to me. I love doing movement like we've been doing tonight. So thank you for that too. Okay, so that was a great thing, Pear, share. And what I hope has happened, I think Stephen really helped us by bringing everyone's voices to this group to share, to think. Everybody has ideas. They might be different. And one of the things I like about this list is somebody might not have thought about listening to music in the dark, in a dark room, but that's like, oh, that might be good. So your idea helped generate ideas of the others. So that think, pair, share is so important for generating ideas and getting people to talk. But it brings equity to a group. And that allows those who might pull back or be quiet to share. Did you know that in groups, often white middle-class males will talk first? And there's a sense that the white middle-class male has been socialized to believe they have something important to say and you need to hear it. And the next person that will talk out in a group is white, a female, because they have been socialized, or we've been socialized to talk and share, have the confidence to do it. We've done it all our lives. And we have something important to say and you need to hear it. The group needs to hear it. And often the white male or white female will take up the space and, but that is not true. There are others that have voice to bring to the table. One of the other things is that some cultures, the parents teach the children not to talk out, not to bring attention to themselves, and to wait to be talked to. Don't ask questions. And so that group is used to sitting back and waiting to be called on. And if others are taking up the space, they may never ever talk or share. So keep that in mind as you're working with your groups, as you're working with students, as you're also bringing yourself into the process of sharing. You have something important to say. All right, so what we're gonna do next, thank you so much for working with me on this. I want you to do a visualization with me so we can focus our attention, thinking about those ways that you take care of yourself. Let's focus on you right now and think about, I want you to close your eyes and think about what are some things that can bring you that inner peace, either by yourself or with others, with your family, with your friends, and also visualize yourself with your friends and where we will be soon, when we will all be together, when we will be able to go out to dinner, to a restaurant, to go to class and hang out with our friends at the campus. And for us, and my colleagues, we can be sitting in our offices and talk and share and walk somewhere to get something to eat or have a cup of coffee together and just collaborate. Those are things that I want to do. So close your eyes for just a moment. Again, take a deep breath and just make yourself quiet and think about what it'll be like to be with your family and your friends, maybe traveling. That's what I can't wait to do, is travel again. And as you're thinking about these things, what makes you feel the best? Maybe who you're with, maybe where you will go. Think about that place that might really make you feel that you just, is your favorite place. I have a favorite swimming place in San Marcos. And I love to go jump into the San Marcos River. And someday I'll get to do that again with my family. We do that. We used to do that all the time. Take another deep breath. Think about that place that makes you feel good. And you'll be there soon. And you'll be with your group. Think about the people around you. Bring those people in. Listen to their voices, their laughter, how they're playing together, children, and eating. Think of those glasses clinking together. You're giving toast, you're greeting each other. Now, as you are thinking about those good places and those good people to be with. For now, while we're being safe and we're taking care of ourselves, our family, maybe you're staying home more because you have parents at home that have underlying conditions that you worry about. And you're making choices to stay home. And those choices mean you're alone sometimes. I'm in my apartment by myself with my cats. I talk to my kids every day, but I really haven't been able to be out to see them much. But it's okay. These kind of things that we're doing right now make it okay. Because I know soon we'll be together. So as we're finishing this visualization, tell your friends goodbye. Tell them you'll see them soon. Think of that place and just breathe. And open your eyes when you're ready, or if they were already open, just come to focus with us. And what we're gonna do next is a fun, creative activity. So now, I hope you have your journal with you, some paper, color pen, something with you. And I'm going to give you a few minutes. And what I'd like you to do is just doodle, draw, color, write anything that you want to do. Maybe with that list of what you like to do, you might want to draw some pictures of those things that you do. You might want to doodle. I put the flower here. I didn't put my doodles in because I didn't know if you'd really understand them. They're kind of crazy. I do a lot of journaling and a lot of doodles. I'm looking for some in here. There's not any, but I like to draw flowers. Sometimes I put words in there, in the leaves and the petals or around it. And then I put in this because I thought this looks really cool. I want to doodle these shapes here. And take a moment, get your pen, pencil, and we're going to take about 5 minutes. And I'm going to put some music on. Don't leave me just because you go, oh, I got other things to do. Hang with me because you're going to see how much fun it is to doodle if you haven't done this in a while. Or even color. I love to color. I put this in to make you think about some different ways. This is a mind map. I like to draw and do my mind maps this way. So if you're in a planning mode or wanting to get some work done, maybe you could draw out your mind map and be thinking about it in different ways. What I'm going to do while you're doing that is putting on some music. I hope you can hear it. My team here will let me know if it's working okay. But I'm not going to talk. I'm going to watch the clock, and we're going to take about 5 minutes just to doodle and write. And then I'm going to ask you, I won't be able to see it today, but I'm going to ask you how it made you feel, and we'll do a chat on that. And then maybe you'll share it with me through email or some way. All right, are you ready? All right, I'm putting on some music. Come on, music. Go ahead and get started while I get the music going. Oh, I know what I need to do. Hang on a second. Y'all get started and I'll take care of this technology. Thank you. Guys, how come my music's not playing?
I don't know.
It's like something's muted.
Can you hear it? Because we can't hear it at all.
I can't hear it either. We had it perfect. Oh, technology.
Is your phone on? I guess it is because I can hear you.
Who knows? So I hope, sorry about the music part, but I hope that you're journaling, you're writing. There, somehow it's kind of. Yes?
Thank you.
take the pause in the music for a time for us to pause. So I want you to think about ways that you started thinking. Were you a little calmer? Did you think about things that you want to do, planning something? And just put something in the chat about how these make you feel. What are you feeling now? Did you do something creative, something you can share with us later? Put something in the chat to tell us how you're feeling now.
Dr. Mitchell, if you wanted to share the PowerPoint again, right now we can see the music screen.
Okay, got it. I think I need to change the share. Thank you for telling me that. And you see my PowerPoint now?
Yes.
Yay, we have success. Okay, so hoping that, yes, Mr. Villano, go ahead.
Khadijah says that she is amused.
I love that. Did that make you feel amused and want to do something?
Abby is relieved. And Shanajala is better. Now I found my favorite crayons.
Yay. Love it.
Diane is calm. Diana is calm.
Yes.
Andrea is centered. Diane is reflective. Abby is inspired. I'm peaceful.
Yay. Those are really, really good.
Ashley is relaxed.
I wish we had more ways that we could share what you have, but I have put on the last slide, you'll see in just a moment, my email address. And I would treasure and be honored if you would send me anything that you made or your list. And then we can do some things with it. You can put your name on it or you don't have to, it doesn't matter. And so as we're finishing out tonight, I would really like for you to think about ways that you could share with us. And also I encourage you to share with your family, show what you did, maybe think of ways to have some family time with children and you or other family members, just to do some of this kind of work. And you know, these words are beautiful, creative, reflective, inspired. All of these words just tell me that this is really something that helps you, like that centered. Somebody said they're centered. It also will help create your focus. So we're worried about being able to do our work. We're worried about doing our homework assignments, but we also have to go to work. We have to take care of our children. Some of you are taking care, having your children learn virtually. So you're dealing with that. So these are things that can help with your focus, not just to help you get centered and calm, but also help you to focus so that you can start really focusing and get that kind of inspired work on your homework that you have to do. And then take some breaks and then go do some more work and you'll find your focus is really strong. So, okay, Stephen, why don't you talk about the survey for just a minute and then I'll close this out for tonight.
All right, so if you would, everyone, you can copy that link, you can and put it into your browser. It's a short survey on your feelings about tonight's presentation. I will also email it out to you. Once I get the list of attendees, I'll be able to email it out to you as well. But if you can complete that, that will help us to know how you felt about the session. And if you want more sessions like this, I know that Dr. Mitchell is interested in offering these more frequently to people. And then it also will help us to know, you know, what other types of sessions would be most beneficial for everyone. So it would only take you a few minutes. If you could do that, that'd be greatly appreciated.
Absolutely. I would love to hear from you in either form, either through emails or contacting me in any way or completing a survey. So my goal, my intention is to bring this kind of work to us in different formats to the university. And I want to hear from those of you that were here, what worked for you, what didn't work for you, what would you like to see more of? And we will continue, I'd love to continue doing this in some kind of format, either as big as this, or maybe just me and Zoom and whoever wants to come join in informally and doing, talking about some of the ways like this of the social and emotional learning and the movement, the yoga movements, the twist and the turns, the stretches and those kind of things. So please, please give us some feedback to know how this worked for you. And also just to know, I'm so honored you were here tonight, that you took time with me to do this. Thank you so much for joining us to do this. And thank you also to our team here with helping us do this. So as we close out, I want to move into what a stage of relaxation again. We want to go back to that piece of just taking a moment to breathe and give ourselves a little bit of closure to tonight. And I'm going to ask you to say some words with me too as we do this, just to help slow us down.
Dr. Mitchell, before we do that, can I interrupt for 1 second?
Sure, go ahead.
We have two things. Were you going to put your contact information up?
Yes, I can go ahead and do that now. It's here on the slide. Let me pull it down just a little bit.
And then we have, Khadija is wanting to know if this is associated with Breathe for Change.
Oh, that's a wonderful question. So yes, so the group Breathe for Change is a national organization, and I'm doing trainings with them right now with teachers across the country. And it's been super exciting. And this format that I did tonight is a lesson plan that they do and teach. And so I brought a lot of the strategies and things that Breathe for Change teaches. I also encourage you, if you like this and want to explore more, you can look to see, and they are offering sessions all the time, either short ones or long ones. And you can go into their website that I had earlier, or just type in Breathe for Change, it'll come up. And you can participate in this with them. I am now certified to teach social emotional learning strategies for Breathe for Change. I'm not one of their trainers, but I can use their work. And so that's what I'm bringing here. And also I'm certified in yoga, who knew? I am planning on, we're looking at ways we can bring movement, social emotional learning to the campus. But also let me know if you want to do anything with Breathe for Change, and you can get connected with them, or I can help you connect, whatever works. I have my picture here, so yay. But that's me always with the coffee cup. I love tea, I love coffee. So I thought that would be a really good way. It's a selfie. I'm not good at selfies, so please forgive the picture. My daughter would say, Mom, you know, that kind of thing. But this is my information. That's my office telephone number. If you leave a voicemail, it'll come straight to me. And then that's my email that I'm highly connected to, and I hope you will send me some good things that you did tonight, or tell me how tonight worked for you. Or if it didn't work for you, please let me know. Any other questions, feel free to put them in as we close out, and we will continue reading the questions and the chats as you communicate and share with us. So let's take that last minute of relaxation, give ourselves a really quick gift of just slowing down for a few more minutes before we take off to go work on homework or get dinner or all those crazy things we have to do in the evenings. And just find a way to slow down, take a deep breath. let it out. Take another deep breath. And then let that out. Take one more deep breath. And what I'd like you to do is think of these words that I have here. It's just a mantra, and I'm gonna say them, and then I'd like you to say it either out loud or in your head, whichever works best for you. But as we are going through this semester, we need to find healing as we have been so in so much trauma, so much stress, so much worry. We look for healing for ourselves, healing for others, and healing for our community. Okay, so in our closure, I can't really get too much, walk away, like exit questions or any of that kind of closure. That usually makes, or turn to your partner, that makes really good closure. So the closure I'm going to ask you to do is a walk away question. And a walk away question means I'm just going to ask you the question. I don't need the answer. I would like you to think in your head. And then maybe this is a question you'll carry with you through the week. Just what we've been talking about all through this time together. In what ways will you take care of yourself in order to take care of others? So I don't really want to answer to that right now, but if you want to send me an email, communicate with me in any way, I'd love to hear from you. Thank you so much for this evening, for all the things that you've done with me tonight. It's been a pleasure and so much fun. And I hope you feel rejuvenated, focused, relaxed, and ready to start this semester. Welcome back to UHD and the semester and all the things that we have to look forward to. So thank you very much. And there we are. Anything else we need to do to close out? Mr. Villano or Dean Schwartz, do we want to do anything else?
No, I think we're good.
All right. Well, thank you guys for being here, and I'll say good night.